Good evening everyone and welcome back to our channel. I am Twinkle Patra from IMA Law College. I am currently a legal intern at Lexis & Company. And in my first video of court, I have told you about section 326B. So here I will resume the rest of the section. And before starting, I would like to share a line that will be very helpful in remembering the section, because earlier I have also told you that the order of hurt under IPC is very confusing. So the line is, illegal property ka confession public servant provoke hokar karega varna safe khelega. So this is a line and I will tell you the importance of this line in my video. So let's just first get started with the section. So 327 deals with voluntary causing hurt to extort property or to constrain to an illegal to an act. It means that if someone is doing a voluntary hurt to some other person with the purpose of extortion, and I have already told you about extortion, so I will not repeat here. If someone do a voluntary hurt with the intention of doing extortion or any act that is illegal in the eye of law, and he do voluntary hurt so that person to whom he is doing the act does something that will lead to extortion, and then the person who is doing this voluntary hurt will be liable for the punishment of 10 years plus fine. And here also, first I will tell you all the section of hurt and then we will move to grievous hurt. So next is section 328. It means causing hurt by means of poison etc. with intent to commit an offence. So this is the extension of section 327. It means that if someone causes hurt with poison or any other thing, and which intend to commit an offence. So if someone does the hurt with poison or any intoxicated substance or unwholesome drug, then he will be under imprisonment of either description, which is of 10 years plus fine. Now let's come to 330. It says voluntary causing hurt to extort confession or to compel restoration of property. It means that if someone voluntarily hurts you for having confession, or he wants you to tell the where the property is, restoration of property मतलब है कि कहाँ पर वो जो तुमने सामान लिया है या चोरी करा है या जो भी सीन होगा उस वक्त, तो वो restoration के लिए अगर तुम्हें hurt कर रहा है कि वो पूछ रहा है बताओ कहाँ पर है, then he will be liable for 7 years of imprisonment plus fine. And this section mainly implies to police officers, because police officers sometimes does voluntary hurt for the confession of that person. Next is 332. It deals with voluntary causing hurt to deter public servant from his duty. It means that if someone is doing voluntary hurt to a public servant that is doing his duty, or the servant that is compelled to do his duty under any supervision or under any superior, and if other person is voluntarily causing the public servant, it means he will be liable for 3 years of imprisonment plus fine plus both. Now next is 334. It says voluntary causing hurt on provocation. It means that if you have been provoked by any third person and then you are causing hurt, you don't know what are you doing, but under the provocation you are doing, then also you will be liable for 1 month and fine. It could be extended to 500 rupees or both. Now 337, it says causing hurt by act endangering life or personal safety of others. It means if you are doing that act that is endangered to someone's life or someone's personal safety, then you will be liable for 6 months plus fine, and fine can be extended to 500 rupees plus both. Now these were the sections of hurt. Now let's come to grievous hurt. Section 329 says voluntary causing grievous hurt to extort property or to constrain to an illegal act. It is same as hurt, but here it is grievous hurt, and we have read grievous hurt before. And do tell me that what is the section, or what is the section in which definition of grievous hurt is given. So it says that the punishment will be of 10 years plus fine. Now let's come to section 331. It says voluntary causing grievous hurt to extortion. The same extortion section. If you will do grievous hurt, then 10 years plus fine will be the punishment. Now 333. It says voluntary causing grievous hurt to debtor public servant. If you will do grievous hurt for to a public servant that is doing his duty, then 10 years plus fine. Now let's come to 335. It says voluntary causing grievous hurt on provocation. If you are provoked to do a grievous hurt, then the punishment will be a four years plus fine. Fine could be extended to 2000 rupees plus both. Now 338 says causing grievous hurt by act endangering life or personal safety of others. It means that if you are doing the act that is endanger for personal safety and that to be a grievous hurt, then punishment will be of 2 years plus fine, and fine could be extended to 1000 another. So in this section of hurt that we are reading from section that is 319, we are reading from section 319. So the punishment that are given is very, very important. You have to remember, you have to retain that what is the punishment of what offense. Now I have told you the line, illegal property ka confession public servant provoke ho ke karega varna safe khelega. It means that illegal property means 327 327 and 329. And you have to just remember section 328 and 336 because they are only different. Otherwise, they are in other sections are in order. So illegal property ka confession means 327, 329. Confessions come in 330 and 331, right? Illegal property 327, 329, 328 हम learn कर लेंगे. उसके बाद 330, 331 confession. अब public servant 333. Now public servant हो गया. Provoke होकर provocation आता है हमारा 334, 335. अब 336 हम learn कर लेंगे. अब बचा 337, 338. वरना सेफ खेलेगा. इट मीन्स सेफ्टी, एंडेंजर्ड सेफ्टी ऑफ एनी अदर पर्सन. सो ऐसे हम इसको याद कर सकते हैं. आई होप आपको ये थोड़ा सा इजी लगे. एंड टिल देन कीप लाइकिंग, कीप शेयरिंग एंड सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल. एंड थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग.